This is Catherine Schmer at Chattanooga State Community College. This is video 2 of the vectors section, and in this video we talk about magnitude and direction. A vector between two points, P being the point x1, y1, z1, and Q being the point x2, y2, z2, is determined by subtracting the coordinates of the initial point from the coordinates of the terminal point. So this would give us vector PQ equals angle bracket x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, z2 minus z1. The magnitude or length is the distance from head to tail of the vector, so we use the distance formula. So the distance formula would give us the magnitude of vector v equals the square root of v1 squared plus v2 squared plus v3 squared. Or if we're using the definition from the previous screen, the square root of x2 minus x1 quantity squared plus y2 minus y1 quantity squared plus z2 minus z1 quantity squared. A unit vector is a vector of length 1. To find a unit vector in the direction of v, divide v by the magnitude of v. So we're dividing the vector by its length, and that makes its length 1. A direction vector always refers to a unit vector in the direction of v. Now this point is actually really important because several of your problems in the homework ask you for a direction vector. They don't specify that they want a unit vector, but we just must know that direction vector is defined to be a unit vector. So example 2 from the guided notes asks us to find a unit vector in the direction of vector 1, 2, 3. So the first thing we want to do is find the length. So we set up the magnitude of v equals the square root of 1 squared plus 2 squared plus 3 squared, since those are the components of our vector. This is the square root of 14, so the length of that vector is square root of 14. Second step is to divide each component by the length. So the first component is 1. So I'll do 1 over square root of 14. Second component is 2, so 2 over square root of 14. And the third component is 3, so I'll do 3 over square root of 14. So the direction vector is 1 over radical 14, 2 over radical 14, 3 over radical 14. Now here's a practice problem that I would have students work through in class, but since this is an online class, we'll just put it in the video. We want to find the component form of the unit vector in R2 that makes an angle of theta equals negative pi over 3 with the positive x-axis. So let's think back to component form. That would be an angle bracket with an x comma y. And let's think back to the unit circle. So I'm going to put an angle of negative pi over 3 with the positive x-axis. So I'm in the fourth quadrant. And I know that the x value of that point is cosine of negative pi over 3 sine of negative, and the y value is sine of negative pi over 3. So cosine of negative pi over 3 is 1/2. Sine of negative pi over 3 is negative square root of 3 over 2. So because I'm on the unit circle, I know that the length of that vector is 1 already. And so my unit vector that makes an angle of negative pi over 3 with the positive x-axis is 1/2, comma, negative square root of 3 over 2. The standard basis vectors in R3 are I, which is the unit vector in the x direction. So that would be 1, 0, 0. J is the unit vector in the y direction, 0, 1, 0. And K is the unit vector in the z direction, 0, 0, 1. We can represent any vector as a sum of the basis vectors. For example, the vector 5, negative 4, 2 can be represented as 5i minus 4j plus 2k. Example 3 asks us to express vector p1, p2 in the form v equals v1i plus v2j plus v3k if p1 is the point 3, negative 8, 4, and p2 is the point 1, 6, negative 2. So our first step is going to be to find the vector. Vector p1, p2 is equal to the terminal point minus the initial point. So that's going to be x components 1 minus 3, y component 6 minus negative 8, z component negative 2 minus 4. Let's simplify that. So we get negative 2 is our x component. So I have negative 2i plus 14j, that's the y component, minus 6k, that's the z component. So we've expressed the vector using I, j, and k. And our last practice problem for this video, express 5i minus 4j plus 2k as a product of its length and direction. So first, let's find its length. We have the magnitude of v equals square root of 5 squared plus negative 4 squared plus 2 squared. So that's the square root of 45. And I can break that down farther. I know 45 is 9 times 5. And then I can take the square root of the 9, so I get 3 square root of 5. So I know that the length is 3 square root of 5, and so the direction is going to be my initial vector with each component divided by the length. So the direction is 5 over 3 square root of 5i minus 4 over 3 square root of 5j plus 2 over 3 square root of 5k. So my vector expressed as a product of its length and direction is going to be 3 square root of 5 and then a large set of parentheses with my direction vector inside. Now notice I simplified the I component to square root of 5 over 3 because I know that 5 divided by square root of 5 is the square root of 5. So you always do want to simplify if possible.